Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. So I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turn me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, I've been scheming. Against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, but how you gon' act?
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
Folder, you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch him hate, watch him lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters. In the mercs, out the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight, set the bar, take flight. Yo, I've been grinding since I'm young and they told me my timing was coming. I've been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame, get the money.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Kansas City Chiefs.
Wei Koo, the kickoff for Atlanta.
Young Wei Koo all set to do the honors, and we are underway from Atlanta. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. To the 29, a gain of four.
Kansas City.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Now a throw for the All-Pro Kelsey is complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First down, Chiefs.
At the 38. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Gets this one to Hill. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
First down, Kansas City.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
Complete.
Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
And the first down, Chiefs.
Mahomes now on first down. Open man is Hill. He's got it. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking themselves and expressing. Let's keep going. We're doing pretty well.
Inside the 15-yard line. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
I
There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Operating for the red zone now, Mahomes. They complete it to Hill. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
At the 9-yard line.
Sammy Watkins for the Kansas City first. From the 2, here's first and goal. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown.
Kansas City.
A 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs take it right down and score on the opening drive. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. Is good to make it 7-0 KC.
Makes the score Chiefs 7, Falcons nothing. Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Brian will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10. At their 25-yard line. They begin with a run by Smith. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Ryan. Guys, man, that's the Pro Bowler Julio Jones. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 15 yards, first down Atlanta. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From midfield now, here's Ryan. It's complete to Jones. Julio Jones!
Three, four, minute man.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. A quick slam to Hill. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39.
Tyreek Hill.
11 yards there, first down.
First down, Kansas City.
Mahomes now on first down. Flushed out right. And that's incomplete.
Well, CD, you know, taking a step back, we're 2 weeks into the season, and you already kind of get the sense that teams are beginning to separate themselves. If you look at the 2-0 teams, and remember, 62% of 2-0 teams ultimately make the playoffs. But Baltimore, Kansas City, Green Bay, Seattle, just to name a few, they look really good.
They certainly do, and in a lot of ways, those are the teams that we expected to be 2-0 at this part of the season. I mean, it's no major surprise. Arizona being 2-0 as well. People talked about them getting better in the offseason. I don't know how many of us thought they'd beat San Francisco in the opener. They did. Then they jumped on Washington this week, and they are 2-0 as well.
Now, on the other side of the spectrum, we know the not good news about teams that start 0-2. The Giants and the Jets both there. Detroit, Cincinnati. So, again, maybe some more predictable names.
Certainly, they are predictable. Again, not a surprise for most of them, although many thought Detroit would be improved at this point. But how about a team that's 0-2 that went through a little bit of a difficult offseason like the rest of us, but even more so because of players being gone? Houston being 0-2 right now. They won the division last year. They had a tough opening schedule with Kansas City and Baltimore.
In the offense staying out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They do go for it. It's Mahomes. Robinson with a big catch. Big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling.
Every play is supposed to get a player's best effort. But on fourth down, that really increases the stakes, doesn't it? What about that catch?
Heck of an effort, picking up the first.
And now that team has to be motivated going forward. They just saw a great effort there. They want to make sure it pays off.
On first down, Mahomes. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to keep it here. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
The track set up the screen. It's complete. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
A gain of 11.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. That play doomed from the start thanks to the defensive effort of Grady Jarrett. This has been a good march down the field, but now they're stuck looking at a second and 14. Throwing now is Mahomes. And that'll be caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. DeMarcus Robinson.
Touchdown, Kansas City.
DeMarcus Robinson. There to make the grab, and the Chiefs have taken the lead. Point
after. All drives that result in points hurt a defense, but when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Point after, right down the middle, and that makes the score 14-7.
Harrison Butker to kick off for Kansas City.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Fielded in the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
First and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Out there for their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Then you might be able to get a two-for-one without ever even giving up the football. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll pull it down. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. On third down, Ryan. It's caught, Jones. And it passed 15 yards there on a Falcon first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On first down, Ryan. And this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Gotta love the catch. I think you gotta love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They've become a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are, and I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing, but I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
He's gonna get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. On second down, here's Smith. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. 4 yards the pickup, first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Now a timeout signal for, and they'll get him with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
21-yard line.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And his kick is good. So, yes, they'll still be down going into intermission, but the deficit is now made even smaller, very manageable.
Yeah, and if nothing haywire happens here in his last couple of precious seconds, they will go into the locker room with a nice bounce in their step, having gotten a little bit closer on the scoreboard.
So, 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something that feels somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation. Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL.